Hello everybody, I'm Balgin Stondrag, and today I want to show off Return to Nangrim, a dwarven adventure from the fine folks at Psychoforge. It is a wonderful adventure of going over mountains into mines and ancient workshops, and generally exploring and having a jolly good time. So let's get in there, shall we? We have an important notice here, of course. The following experience is not a fully-fledged demo nor a vertical slice. However, it contains some selected features in alpha state to give an impression of the look and feel of the final game. Main features like combat or the Crystal Garden are not yet available in this build. The Crystal Garden sounds very interesting. I must say I'm looking forward to finding out what that might be. Now we're going to be treated to a beautiful introduction with voiceover. Unfortunately, there's no subtitles for it yet, and the voice is a little bit on the quiet side. So let's listen quietly together and hope we can make out what it says. And if not, I'll try and summarize it at the end. And of course, we have lovely motivational messages on the loading screen. Ah, here we are.
They came as a whisper, words so quietly wrapped that the truth may not hear, until that whisper became a growl, impossible to ignore, impossible to outvoice. We were not prepared. That which came upon us lied far beyond our imagination, our plan. Strategies, defense, in vain. The accomplishment of generations, the history of families, their joy, their sorrow, shattered in the blink of an eye. We stood strong, axes and hammers drawn. Our army, the guardians with their best beards, every beard. The great gates fell, and what followed after soon sealed our fate. In the depths of the mountains, a stone beard uses a mannerly stone's glow to separate night from day, darkness from light. Our glow has not yet gone out. We will not make room for the dark. In the midst of the chaos, I hid away our most precious treasure, and in this hour that I know my time has come, I will pass this world knowing that victory is ours, if not today, certainly in a tomorrow that will soon come. By the names of the fallen kings, may Tal'Dorei give us his strength.
So there we have it. I hope you were able to make out some of that. I was, but I did struggle a little. This is, again, not a final product, so hopefully the voiceover will be easier to hear in the future. Or maybe it's because I turned down the game volume a little bit so you'd be able to hear me better.
What happened?
So here we are in a fine mountain clearing. It seems our dwarven adventurer has had a rather rough night and is just come to his senses, opening his bleary eyes and staring around. We have sky up there and a roof overhead. So we've at least got some kind of shelter, but look at all this snow. This is not going to be the warmest weather out there at all.
Ugh. It's cold.
I woke up with an unbearable headache.
Where am I? What am I doing here? And most importantly, who am I? I'm shaking and it's getting darker. I should look for shelter.
Backpack. I'll need this for sure.
So one really nice thing about our player character is that he is not afraid to speak his voice.
I can't get over that bridge without repairing it first.
You know you got a point there, my friend. Taldir, that bridge, it's going to need some mending. Let's see what we can find. Well, here are some loose
the
planks.
The way leads over that bridge, but it's so desolate. It's even missing some planks.
And there's some planks. All right, let's see if these will do the job.
Fair enough.
Well, it's not going to win any awards, but it's functional enough. Let's trot on over and see what we can find up ahead. Maybe some shelter from the cold. Well, that doesn't
look good. Those barricades block the way.
Well, that's all boarded up. We're going to have to find a way to get those boards out of the way. Maybe a claw hammer or a screwdriver or spanner or something. Or there's also this.
Those barricades block the way.
You're all right, Taldir. I was busy.
The head of an axe. I've got the head of an axe. Now, if Taldiron means me well, there might be a chance I'll find the corresponding handle.
So, as Taldir commented, we got an axe head, and if we can find some kind of stick or plank or board, or maybe even a broken old axe haft that we can jam in there and try and make do with, that'd probably be a great help. Now look, there's some wood here. Maybe this will help, although it's from some sort of broken barrel. Okay, so we got bits of wood that we could use. But, aha! Here we have something that looks like a stick, with even something wrapped around it as a grip.
The luck of a dwarf!
Some objects can be combined with others, so let's absolutely do that. I'm going to go in here, and I'm going to combine the axe head with the obvious handle.
A rusty old axe.
Well, it may be rusty, Taldir, my friend, but it's all you've got. Let's test
firmly
it out over
barricaded.
Here. Here's Taldir. Oh, we want to get rid of this as well. We don't want to have to step over it. So here we got
a red glowing shroom.
A red mushroom that glows. And some more wood. I also noticed a nice green plant over here, so I'm going to go pick that up as well. Because it'll be nice to pick up at least one of everything. Try and get a bit of a good feel for what we're doing. Ah. So, as we pick things up, the herbarium. Let's see. We get information about them. Here we have our red glowing mushrooms and our northern ice mint. And I'm not going to take too much time stopping to read all of these because the demo is currently publicly available. So if you want to go play it and try it out, by all means do. And read about these things to your heart's content. Meanwhile, however, we've got a bridge to cross. And let's jog a little. Actually, let's not. Let's be steady. You know, these old boards, they're a bit rickety. And we want to get to the other side of this barricade, because I think I can see hinges.
Here comes Taldir.
Here comes Taldir indeed.
Here we go. Let's keep moving. Finally. Let's see what's behind that door.
Absolutely, my friend. Let's all go see what's behind that door. Keep your torch close when darkness approaches. Creatures from the deep may not see well, but their other senses are razor sharp. Well, we'd better be careful then around such creatures. Wouldn't want to go stumbling into too much trouble now, would we? But hopefully this load screen will be behind us soon, and I believe any moment now...
The Citadel! I should take a look around.
A dwarven training site. I found shelter in something that looks like a citadel. Maybe I can find some clues what this place is. Maybe I find someone else alive. You know, that'd be a great treat. But for now, let's just explore. So we're in a nice big hall. There's this big standing stone in the middle. So let's go take a look at that. A monolithic rock formation that seems to have been worked by hand. Runes are carved into the stone. I think it's not the first time I've encountered one of these. Maybe there's some hidden meaning behind them. Well, we do have other journal entries here. Bahadur's entries. And it seems he was given the book and then it's been passed on to us. Now, I don't see any actual inscriptions on the stone, so maybe that's something to look forward to. But oh look, here at the base of the stone, there's certainly a piece of writing.
Here, Bargon, could you please prioritize my order? Also, this time, please do it yourself. It's the second time that Dundaron has bound the book, and again the pages fell out flying through the citadel. I know you are not only a Giskriban, but also a teacher, and that you believe that something will come out of that stone, but I'm not going to tolerate a book that is falling apart again. There are also still pages spread around the citadel. Teach him a lesson and let Dundaron gather them together. Tardagon Fringinar.
So, it seems that Bagon is responsible for Dundaron, who's done a terrible job.
Hey, I'm going to take that. Written, but maybe I can find Tardagon or Bagon somewhere.
Indeed. Oh, look, here's something that looks like a key.
I should search the scriptorium. Hopefully there's something that brings me further.
That sounds like a nice idea, but I want to explore a little more first. So these red mushrooms seem to grow almost everywhere. And I'm imagining with the information we get on the herbal properties of mushrooms... Don't worry, I've seen that. We might get some kind of potion brewing system or cooking food in the future. What's this say?
Here, Frinbard. A lonesome warrior came wandering our kingdom. His garments were filthy and he half dead of thirst. He said the Nimbor Mountains he had to climb. Foolish he is with the equipment that he has. Nay, real dwarf would ever try such a daring undertaking with a cankered axe like his and his boots worn out, allowing cold to move in. Send him off, I would, but gracious as the heart of our king is, he advised us to accommodate him and prepare equipment for his adventure. Argaran already made his famously delicious Frinsentin pie, and Balastrian it delivered boots of the finest fur as well as chevril gloves from Eshgard. But how is he supposed to climb with just a lousy axe? Assigned by the king was Haldor to forge him the Snowbeard's famous axe. But how should it be? The drunkard has already passed out in the tavern. Why is Borjal even getting served in the morning? Either way, I'll try and find out more and send you the details of the workpiece.
So it seems there's a work order not yet complete. Perhaps we can forge this axe if we find all of the details. So once again, this place is open to the air. Looking down, we see the standing stone, and here, some unfortunate individual who the sands of time have not been kind to. I don't know if he hadn't finished putting on his armor or if some of it has been absolutely destroyed. But let's have a read of this. Dandaron's duties. So this would be Dandaron. Open duties. Get book fittings. Choose fabrics for girdle books. Transcribe Fergnas's book 3 times. Pick more of those red mushrooms. I love those mushrooms. Note to myself. Clean up Scriptorium before Bagon finds out about the mush spilling. So it sounds like Dandaron spilled some mushrooms and Bagon, noticing the mushroom shortage, requested some more, but hasn't found out about the accident yet. I mean, if he hasn't found out by now, he probably never will. But there's another note here. Ah, so this will be part 2 of the previous letter. Here, Frimbard. Haldor's apprentice gave me some more details. The axe is called Winter Strike, and with its light 34.8 royal pounds, it is perfectly made for such an adventure. Unfortunately, the exact recipe is unknown, and asking Haldor, well, allow me to say that this is not an option. The apprentice says that its head is 33 4/5 times heavier than its wooden handle, but what does someone like me know? It's up to a master blacksmith that the honour of the king must not get tarnished. The apprentice found a sketch in Haldor's forge. Oh, and not to forget the special alloy needed for this weapon. 2 in number, if I recall correct. Only if I'd remember the name. Either way, don't use the expensive iron or wood. Oh, so maybe it doesn't have a wooden handle. Perhaps it has a metal handle. And we're not to use the expensive ingredients. Okay, that's good to know. Although, perhaps that... I didn't pick that up. I should do that. Because if I need to look at that later, it would be good to have it on me. Ah, look at these fine carvings on the walls and the torches. The torches are still lit. Who lit the torches? They're rather high up. So someone must have climbed up there. Maybe they got a footstool or a stepladder. It certainly helps make the place feel warmer, though, so we don't just feel enshrouded in these cold stone walls. Now, what does this say? That would be Brimfels, from where we came. This would be a mine entrance. Ah, the scriptorium. And the last door would be forge. Well, to the scriptorium we go. We have a key, so let us use it. This'll be nice. There should be lots of books and documents in here. Although, with the terrible state of those boarded up entrances outside, the place feels rather abandoned. Maybe most of the important documents were taken away when my fellow clansmen abandoned this hold.
Well then, dusty books and rotten chairs.
All right, Taldi, don't be too dismissive. Now, what have we here? The Mountain Throne. That would be a song. Under the northern mountains old lies the glorious kingdom of stone, the mighty kings of iron and gold reigning ever since on the mountain throne. It's almost far over the misty mountains old, but not quite. And we have a button here. And music. And singing. It sounds like Taldir is singing the song.
The mighty kings of iron and gold.
Now, if I close this, will he continue to sing? No, it fades off after a few seconds. What a shame. It might be nice to have him sing a song as he's going around. Oh, there's a chest there, but here, a body and a note.
So, if I'm putting everything together correctly, this must be Bagon.
Dandaron, I hope you don't read this letter as it means that I am dead and you are in danger too. Those voices from the mines. Something terrible is going to happen. The Stone Widows coming further up the tunnel. The storms. Not to mention the incident with Endon. There is something going on, and I'm not talking about the Cabal theories of those hidden stone cults. Dandaron, I might just be losing my mind, but still, if you read that letter, please leave as far as you can. There's something coming. I will not abandon my post, but you are not bound to anything. You could grow into something big. Please don't waste your potential for us old beards. May Taldoran watch over you. Bagon.
And here, we have Bagon's remains by the look of it.
A key to the mine.
Bagon's letter said something about a danger that emerges from the mines. I should go and explore that. Well, I'll also open this. A basic spoon. We have a spoon. We do have a spoon. And it is very much certainly a spoon. We can pick it up, turn it round, look at it from lots of different angles. Yes. In fact, we can do that with almost every single item we have here. They can be inspected and turned around. We can see the gills on the other side of the mushrooms. It's very nice. Lots of nice attention to detail. Obviously, the inventory is still a work in progress and not quite finished yet. But I see light behind here, which makes me want to explore. And there's something here on this shelf. Legends and Tales of Arafin, Part 1. The Tale of Fargun Simarin the Miner. And there's a lot of pages to this. I could sit and read this for absolutely ages, but I shouldn't really do that, because obviously you're here to see gameplay. And that's something I can do. Maybe I'll do that as a separate thing at one point. You know, after I've finished playing today.
Lecture 1. Reading.
Even if reading is considered a basic requirement, careful and accurate reading must be mastered by every young beard and braid. Some text carries secrets and hidden information.
All right, I found the first page. Now let's see what this is all about.
Which means there may be some secrets hidden in here. I'd love to read through this at some point later on and see if there's some obvious hints to something I should be doing. And actually, the miner. So yes, this will probably relate to what I'm going to be doing just next. Let's press on though and see what we can find in the mine. A Stonebeard is only as strong as the stone beneath his feet. I believe Stonebeard is the name of the clan. And Taldir here, he's been abroad for some time, doing something, maybe studying or working a trade, and now that he's come back to his homeland. Oh, it's terrible. Everything's abandoned or ruined. That's not the mine, is it? That's the forge. No, we want to go this one way for the one shaped like a shield. And off we go to some dark, gloomy tunnels where there may be danger. In fact, we can almost count on it. There we are. We're out in the open air again. And I see more red mushrooms. I also see something new over here. A nice kind of flower. Let's go take a closer look at it and pick it up. Ah, golden crown beard. So now we have three plants in our herbarium. Our knowledge is growing. And down here, that looks a bit like the mountain mint, but it also looks slightly different. Oh, let's not get those boots wet. We've got a nice few boards to go across here as a bridge. Some ash and tamarisk. What do we know of ash and tamarisk? Strengthening when cooked. So maybe it can be used to make some kind of strength potion or strengthen the effect of other ingredients. Let's go back across the way and look for this mine. Obviously, it's not going to be over the edge of one of those cliffs there. And as we look up, there's a nice wooden observation platform with a beam that might be used to reach it. There's banners up there on the stones. Perhaps indicating ownership. Or stating, this is our territory. Here we are, this is our claim, this is our mine, and nobody else is coming in. Oh, look at that nice mine track.
An abandoned mine tunnel. What better place to find some ores?
Absolutely, Taldir.
Or those looking for ores.
Ah, those looking for ores indeed. Now, what does this say?
Lecture 2. Gathering resources.
A forge cannot be fired without wood, and all those precious objects and weapons cannot be crafted without ores. Gather them. We shall do that.
The page again.
Oh, look at that. There's dirty, reddish-purplish smears on the ground. They look rather unpleasant, and I think we can see where they lead. Let's go take a closer look at this. Well, we've got a key, so let's pick it up.
A key to the forge.
Ah, I think we might be going back there soon. I did not believe that old librarian. I thought that old buffer had just buried his nose too far in his books and lost his mind, but as I'm lying here in my blood, by Tal'Darran, was I wrong. They, or it, is coming from the deep tunnels. That stone widow did not act normal. Never have they come so close to the surface, nor did they hunt alone. It seems like something has driven them further up the tunnel. I believe the word he meant to write was tunnels, but alas, the Overseer never did finish this note.
So he's the local mine Overseer.
Well, dear friend, I hope you won't mind me if I just set to work gently. I'm sure you'll keep watch over my endeavours, although I doubt you'll warn me if any dangers should come. Now, this here is just the tool I need. Let's go grab it.
A pickaxe.
Now what's down this way? I see more mushrooms. I'm going to leave them there for now, as I don't need them. And the light is useful, but there appears to be a note left here. Where were we? Notes. Pages.
Lecture 2. Forging.
That's lecture 3, Taldir. You're not so good on the numbers here. This gives me concern about the mixing of ingredients that is to come. Now, as you have all the resources you need, it's time to head to the forge and start crafting. Make sure to always have an eye on the furnace's temperature. Forging or smelting at the wrong temperatures will destroy your workpiece. Even though these waste clumps can be molten back to their original ingredients, there's always a loss. Well then, let's head back and gather some ingredients. Also, I see here from the instructions in the top right that I am to seek out the killer of the mine overseer. I mean, it's not safe to work while whatever did that could still be about. And here I see some wooden boards, so it's time for Taldir to do his best Jack Nicholson impression and hack his way through them with this crude axe. There we go, lovely. Now, what kind of dangerous foes could lurk down here? I see beautiful lighting from crystals and... oh, some kind of many-legged corpse. This looks like some kind of nasty giant spider.
What is this ugly beast?
A giant stone widow has killed the mine overseer. A strange behavior even for this type of creature. There seems to be something down in the tunnels, but I can't go down there without equipment.
Before I can start to forge something, I need to gather the necessary resources, which are...
Oh, Taldir, that's not a good sign. Well, let's at least pick up this.
What beautiful gems there are.
Beautiful gems indeed. We can just pick them up with our bare hands. But first, let's get that pickaxe ready and set it to work. Gold. Well, that's going to be incredibly valuable. And I think I will take this back with me as well.
Oh, what beautiful gems.
I think I'd like a little more gold to take with me before I go back to the forge. I mean, here's Taldir, you know, showing he can swing a pickaxe with the best of them. Let's go get some nice metal. Gold is a soft metal, and if we're going to make some equipment, we might want something a little more sturdy. Oh, that's a durable node, isn't it? A vein of ore. Oh, what's this? Is this gold as well? It might be. Yes, it is. Okay. Well, let's go looking for some harder metal. There's bound to be some somewhere here in the mine. Here we are. That looks a little rougher. Ah, iron. Magnificent. Just what we need, I think. Wonder if perhaps we have a nice mining song that he could be singing while he works. Oh, there's some more on the wall. Let's just go grab a bit more of that. And now, I'll head back to the forge and see what I can make. The spider that slew the mine overseer. Well, it's been boarded up and it doesn't seem to be a threat anymore, but then who boarded it up? The mine overseer might have done before succumbing to his wounds. It's hard to say. Well, now back we go towards the citadel. I do like the way this is all laid out, you know, nice little areas all connecting to each other. And we get to go around meandering. I'm not going to go up there. You can do it if you want to. In fact, I'm going to let you know, you can get up there, and you can even get a little bit higher, almost to the top of the cliff. But for now, let's head back inside, where it's nice and warm again, and no chill breeze. Because, let me tell you, walking around out there in the snow, in the amount of armour that Taldir appears to be wearing, doesn't matter how tough he is, he's eventually going to start feeling the cold. So when he gets back inside, it'll be a good time for us to stamp our feet and shake ourselves a bit, maybe swing our arms around, warm ourselves up a little. And indeed, soon we'll be warming ourselves by the fire of a nice hot furnace. And we won't need a pickaxe for that, so let's put this away. And head back to the forge, which should be this one, if I remember correctly. Now, this workshop should be familiar to many of you who have seen older videos featuring this game. It was one of the very first areas that we had access to.
Let's get to work.
Aye, let's get to work, Taldia.
There must be some plans from the smith flying around.
Yeah, steady on. He's not afraid to raise his voice, is he? Right, what have we here? Duldarin. As much as I appreciate your ingenuity, welding a stone key with tin is not a permanent solution. That thing broke in two pieces again as soon as I lifted it from the table. Remember, keep an eye on the detail and you'll see which materials you can use. Concerning the stone key with its golden engravings, I guess that should be clear now, isn't it?
There's a broken stone keychain on the table. Maybe that letter is talking about that one.
There is indeed, but let's pick up some of these as well. A basic spoon plan. A basic cup plan. A light battle axe plan, not for the special axe. The Art of Smelting, Treatise 1. So here we have a nice book of information on the fine art of smelting metal ores. A number of the pages appear to be missing. I wonder if we will be able to find those missing pages and add them into the book, possibly even affecting some kind of repairs. Who knows, but for now I'm just going to pick this up and hope that I can complete it at some point in the future. There's also a potato here, so let's have that. And another one. Maybe we can do some baked potatoes in the forge. Or even slice them up and fry them. Well now, we're looking to make a weapon, so what would we need for that?
There must be some plans from the smith flying around.
All right, Taldir. Alloys containing iron. For iridium, one platinum and something else. I presume some iron.
The hammer hits the anvil.
Yes, it does, Taldir. Glad to see you getting the basic idea there. Now, let's see. For a light battle axe, we're going to want one wood, five iron, one bronze and one dur steel. We're going to want the forge in the third temperature bracket. So, let's go to the furnace and add some wood. And then if we go back to the forge, we also want some wood here. And if we go to the foundry, I'm going to want to smelt some iron. Can I get some iron at this temperature? I can. That's wonderful. I'm going to want four more. Excellent. And I'm going to want some bronze. Now, bronze is an alloy, isn't it? And it contains tin and quite a lot of copper. So I'm going to go to this supply chest over here and pick up some things. I'm going to take some copper ore. and some tin ore, some Dur steel, and let's see if I can smelt myself some bronze.
The ore needs smelting.
So, I'm wanting copper and tin. I'm not sure how much more copper, so I'm going to go 3-to-1 ratio, which isn't about right.
Looks like a clump of waste.
Now, I'm going to put my clump of waste in there and try to recycle it. Try and melt it down and separate out the ingredients into their constituent parts. There we go. Sometimes it's possible that the reason a combination will fail is that the forge is too hot. So let's lower that temperature. There's our bronze. And you know, I think I'll make one more just to be on the safe side. There we go. Now, I'm going to go back to the forge and I'm going to want my 5 pieces of iron, my 1 of bronze, my 1 of Dura steel, and I'm going to want the temperature to be a bit higher, so I'm going to open up the flaps again. And I'm going to need to put some more wood in the furnace. Now, the fourth part of the furnace, the final heat, requires a different wood, a special wood that burns much hotter. For now, though, let's hope this is correct. Is this correct? Oh, it is. It even shows me I've got the correct amount of ingredients there. That's really useful.
Looks like a clump of waste.
Oh, something's gone wrong there. What was it, the temperature? It seems to be in this third part. Let's try... Oh, I need more iron. Well, in that case... Back to the foundry. Let's separate this out as much as we can and recover what we can from it. Alright, we're going to need a little more iron. And I'm going to take a bit of black oak as well, just to see if that helps. Now, currently, that chest contains unlimited resources.
Let's heat the furnace.
Let's add a little black oak to really whoosh it up there. See if I can break this. Oh, wrong wood, wrong wood. There we go. So. Ah, there we go. I must have just been that little bit too hot.
Ah, aye.
Alright, task completed. And maybe, I want to make a few more things as well. Oh dear, that's unfortunate.
A basic cup.
You're gonna fuck out, who is it?
There must be some plans from the smith flying around.
Well, I've made the light axe and it can't be too much further to go now. Clearly that must have been the strange sound of some ancestral communication. I do believe that Taldir will receive communications from the ancestor spirits coming through to help him at times. Let's get that axe in hand, just in case we need it. And head back out to the mine. And let's hope we don't get into too much trouble there, because, I mean, we've got a nasty weapon, right? If we come up against a stone widow or something else equally dangerous, we might be able to take care of it. Then again, Taldir seemed a bit groggy when he woke up, a little confused as to who he was, so maybe he won't be quite ready to use it properly yet. Let's go and find out, though. We don't even have our torch to stay in the light. Alright, I'm gonna take a little bit of a run at this. Just scurrying along to the tunnel. Let's get back inside, under the ground. It feels so much safer here, more natural. I've forged a weapon and equipped myself. I'm ready to find out what is waiting down there. Absolutely. Too right, Taldia. Let's go find out together. Now here we have a large portcullis blocking the way. This looks very hot and very dangerous. I do not feel confident in leaping across onto that wheel or those wooden beams, so I'm not even going to try it. There's a mine track down there. Let's approach this portcullis here and see what happens.
It seems you have reached the end of this Return to Nundrum playable teaser. By Tal'Doran's beard, I remind you that this is not a demo or a vertical slice. I haven't swung my axe, nor did I smash some of those eight-legged ugly creatures with the hammer that I will find later, for sure. Never judge a dwarf by the adventures he has not yet gone on.
And there we have it. That is the end of the current playable teaser. I hope you've all enjoyed this presentation, and I'll look forward to more in the future. But for now, I'm going to leave this one here. If you've enjoyed what you've seen, why not go grab the demo for yourself and play it a little bit? You know, see if you like it. For now though, I'm going to say bye-bye everyone. See you all soon.